हाई एंड वेलकम बैक एवरी वन टू कविता दिवाकर्स क्लास. आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल. 99% ऑफ पीपल वॉचिंग मी आर दोज हु आर ट्राइंग टू लर्न इंग्लिश, राइट? एंड मोस्ट ऑफ यू माइट इम्पल्सिवली कंप्लेन मी सेइंग दैट मैम आई डू नॉट हैव अ फेवरेबल इन्वायरमेंट और आई डू नॉट हैव अ प्रॉपर स्पीकिंग पार्टनर टू लर्न इंग्लिश विद. एंड दिस इज़ वाई ऑल्दो आई एम ट्राइंग सिंस लास्ट 3 years, 4 years, but I am incapable of speaking fluent English even today. And I know 95 to 98% people would have the same complaint and they would come to me saying the same thing, right? And I want to say that although you do not have an environment, why don't you create that environment on YouTube? There are so many creators speaking wonderful English on YouTube from where you can hear so many sentences and try speaking on your own. Right, but no, people are still not doing that. Now I felt that the videos I upload after every 5 or 6 days is just not sufficient for you to learn English, because practicing after every 5 or 6 days for just a couple of minutes is not going to help you improve your language skill. You need to do something daily to observe that result in 6 months, right? So I shall be sharing 3 strategies which will not just help you improve your English, but you will instantaneously start to speak to yourself. You will start to get some sentences and many more benefits. Okay, before starting with the actual video, I want to thank everyone. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. You all are just a blessing to me. I feel you all are the reason for my smile. This is the reason I'm smiling on YouTube. If you go and look my first video, I was not at all smiling. I didn't know what to make, what all to create, but I just had to do something. But now I'm completely sure about my audience, what my audience likes, what kind of audience watches me, what audience expect from me. And I also know that there are so many students who are willing to learn from me through offline or online mode. I have not started it yet. I am thinking to. I shall inform here publicly if I start anything, okay? And thank you everyone for the advices and suggestions you had given me in the previous video. So let's start with the strategy. The strategy number one I'm going to share here is reading. Now, when I say reading, many of you might say reading has become very boring and it has become age-old practice. We're not going to do that. We need to learn speaking. Okay, and many of you might say that we already know how to read. We just do not know only to speak. Okay, so just talk about speaking. But my dear friends, I will tell you the story of my own life that I have been reading since I was a child. I have read so many books of my own subject. I'm not talking about novels and everything. I have read my subjects aloud. Okay, when you speak aloud, when you try reading aloud, you get to hear your own sentences. And this is much more important than listening to somebody in front. Okay, just do not waste your time talking to people. Start with the basic reading practice first. I'm telling you, everyone will not correct you. They will just listen to you, try understand the meaning, and they will speak their own sentences. They will not correct what mistakes you did. Before speaking up, you need to have some warm up. The way while exercising, you need to get some warm up. For any dance class, you need to get flexibility for which you are taught some basic steps. The similar way, before speaking, you need to practice a lot of reading. Now, whether you are beginner, intermediate or an advanced person, you need to read. For beginner level, you will learn basic sentences. For advanced people, you will get to read various vocabularies. And vocabularies are going to help you create advanced sentences. And complexity of the sentences will be created only through reading. I read even today. I had started reading since I was in class 7th. If you look at my previous videos, you will know that my teacher used to make me read. And I have read a lot of subjects aloud. I don't speak or read in my mind. It does not come out, then it is not going to come out even if you speak. It is going to help you if you read aloud. So make it a habit of reading anything aloud. Now you will have to read something which interests you. For example, if you like comics, you can read comics. If you like stories, I usually prefer reading stories, so I go towards stories. And if you like reading newspaper, you can ultimately go and read newspaper. That is the cheapest practice you could do, and you find newspaper everywhere. So start reading first every day. Okay, every day. Second strategy is to listen to the audios. Now when I say audios, YouTube is just more than enough. It is more than enough, but don't rely on basic conversation, because everyone I've seen many a times, how are you, tell me something about yourself, introduce yourself, that has become so basic. You're not going to learn any new sentences if you keep listening to basic conversation. Forgetting something advanced, listen to something better. For example, TED Talks. These are the people who speak very fluently, okay, or some beautiful English speaker you like. And of course, you can even watch my videos if you wish to. No compulsion. If you like, you can watch. Rather than that, I would say you can watch English movies with subtitles. In the beginning, rely on subtitles, but if you feel that you've started understanding, don't even look at the subtitles. Try memorizing the sentences in your own way, because when you listen to the audio, try speaking to yourself the same way. This is my strategy number 3. After reading, after listening, you will have to speak. And speaking to yourself is the most and most appropriate method to speak English properly. If you are practicing reading, if you are listening to multiple audios, and if you are not speaking to yourself, the first 2 points are waste. First, become confident within you. Okay, and there are some people who complain me that I can speak English, but I'm just unconfident. This is the only problem, that I'm just unconfident. Rest is everything fine with me. Now tell me, I am not looking at anyone, I'm looking at the camera. Do you feel that I'm unconfident? No, because I have practiced almost 30, 35 or 40 videos up till now on my YouTube journey. And if you go and look at my first video, you will see I was so very scared. I was so unconfident. So confidence is nothing but a regular practice. The more you practice, the more confident you become. It's that simple. There is a fret inside that when I go in front of this person, maybe this person would use some difficult words in front of me and I won't be able to answer this person. I'll go blank and then I'll not be able to speak. This will happen only if you have not practiced enough in front of yourself. If you have not heard your voice enough times, okay? This is going to happen to you every time you will go and speak to someone. But you will have to face this fear. Slowly and steadily, confidence will be built. Confidence is not going to come in a single day, my dear friends. It is not that simple. Okay, now all the strategies to recap is strategy number 1, read. Every day you will have to donate some time for reading. After that, you will have to listen to some audios every day. And then after listening to reading and audio, try speaking to yourself. Everything has to be summarized and spoken by yourself in your own words. Until you do that, forget English. And if you do that, remember that English is going to start slipping by your tongue, because when we read a lot, we learn sentences automatically, and that automatic learned sentences are the ones which comes out when we try speaking to someone. Translation is not going to help you. Grammar in depth is not going to help you. Speaking is a skill. It's not just a language. Okay, so I will end the video here. Once again, I want to thank everyone. Thank you so much for improving my confidence on YouTube. And the way you people are improving my confidence on YouTube, I will try my level best to improve your speaking confidence in front of others. Okay, so if you like my content, please hit like and subscribe to my channel. And one more thing, that I have created an Instagram account, and that link will be mentioned in the description too. You can check it out. And if you wish to connect with me personally, you can connect with me on my Instagram page. I would be happy to see you there. See you in the next class. Till then, bye bye, namaste, and take care, everyone.